Guys, welcome back to the stream. This is your Gamer Khan here. So guys, I hope you guys have watched all my previous videos. This particular video, I'm just going to discuss about the current expenses which can incur to you while building a PC. So these are all updated price as of today, which is 9th or 18th of September. So I have actually created three tabular columns for you guys to be on an easier side. So first is the type of build, whether it is gaming or mining, or it is mining isolated. And I will also will be updating an alternative mining Intel rig also on the next setup. So right now I only had enough time to compile about a proper gaming plus mining rig, which is a Ryzen based one. So guys, this is my pick. So for my CPU, as I mentioned earlier, Ryzen 5 5600X is a very good option. It's a future proof one. You can, if you have a little bit more money, like you have $30 plus to spend, you can even go for the Ryzen 7 series, which is even further better. Then we have RAM. At any RAM is okay, but I preferably will go for any of these three companies, either G-Skill, Crucial or Corsair. Kingston is also good. But while buying a RAM, make sure that you buy at least 3000 MHz RAM of DDR4 variety, and you should have a kit. Don't buy separate RAMs. Sometimes the compatibility issues may arise. But generally, same brand, same MHz will work fine. So, but why you take the risk? There are available kits online which are much cheaper than buying the RAMs individually. For example, you can get a G-Skill 16GB into 2. 3000 plus megahertz RAM for 13,000 rupees. Then you have a motherboard, as I mentioned earlier. My best choice will be Gigabyte 450 Aeros Pro Wi-Fi motherboard, which has inbuilt Wi-Fi, 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi within, which is very needed in the upcoming generations because all devices are going for 5 gigahertz or higher bandwidths. So it requires around roughly to 9,000. This down arrows all indicate the price drops. These things have dropped. The prices have come down significantly in the last 2 months. You can check with Amazon or any other online retailer if you are not believing me. So next, my graphics card of choice is still RTX 3060 LHR. Hope you would have seen my Doom playing video after mining without no overclocking, nothing. And it was doing perfectly good, and I got good enough frames per seconds, and that is more than sufficient, I think. So that will come around across between 52 to 55,000, as I told you earlier. So right now the price has come down in some of the websites around 52,500. Okay, so go for, if I am to choose, I will choose ASUS TUF series because of the three fans, or you can go for the twin blade edition from Zotac or any other similar brands, which will be cheaper than this. Okay, then power supply, this you can't compromise, guys. Go for a gold rated power supply. We can choose from Corsair, NZXT, Deepcool, or any brand you want. Corsair has a highly customizable power unit which you can add additional wires as direct pins, which is not seen in most of the power units now of the older times and now times, but most of them are following the same pathway now. The advantage of having NZXT is they have a 10-year warranty, but the price is a little bit high compared to Corsair. Corsair will cost you around $9,600. Then storage, it's strictly personal. I would go for a 512GB internal drive, and I myself have a Crucial MX500, as I mentioned earlier, which cost me around $5,000. Around in 2020, in the mid 2020, and I've been using it since. It has been no absolute beauty regarding booting time and all those stuff. So far, no issues. And only a disadvantage is I have to use one of my NVMe slots for that, which is theoretically you can use for mining with the appropriate gear. You can attach one more graphics card to that if you want. Then I have a HDD. I would always go for a normal hard drive, which is not essential if you are not going to play more than one or two games. 1 TB SSD internal is enough. You can spare this $3,800 for something else like miscellaneous stuff like mining gear and all. Okay, cabinet, I don't have any personal choices, but my personal opinion is tempered glass is a heat puller. You will not get enough cooling if you use tempered glass on a side of your PC. Eventually you will have to open it up and keep it open. That doesn't give you much choice, right? So if you are into mining, proper mining, or if you are into overclocking or doing anything, some high-end stuff, please don't buy tempered glass towers. Go for the normal metallic ones with good enough number of holes on the sides, front, back, wherever possible, and more the number of fans with good position. That is important. Good position will be better. I am currently using a thermal take case. I always misspell it as thermal at K. I don't know why I do it. It is a thermal take. You can go for Li & Li or whatever, Corsair or whatever you can. But my CPU tower is an ATX form factor. Please note that ATX form factor is more important than the light RGB lighting. Please note that. So go for a cabinet with a good ATX form factor. Mine is, as I told, it's thermal take. And it cost me around $5,500. Risers, you may use it, you may not use it, depending upon number of cards you want to put. If you are going to put a twin blade edition of RTX 3060 LHR, you can easily mount three cards into this Pro Wi-Fi motherboard, given your cabinet has enough space for other stuff. Okay. Which generally all modern day cabinets have. Mine has enough, more than enough space to mount two more graphics cards, but I'm not doing it. I've already packed it up. As I told you earlier, mine is mining in background. So you can see here, this is NVIDIA GTX 300, which is a large card, and a smaller 1050 Ti is also there. So that's it, guys. Then you can buy any riser, doesn't matter, because both these risers have no guarantee, warranty or anything, stuff like that. Some might not even work. If you buy it in a bundle, it is much cheaper. But there has been a couple of reviews in India by a lot of buyers in Amazon and all. Yeah, all of that, I found out this Pi Plus variety is quite good. You can buy Pi Plus bundle as cheap as 600 or 500 rupees. You can try that. But my recommendation is that if you are not going to use that, don't buy it. Especially when you have a motherboard like B450RS Pro Wi-Fi, which has three full-size PCIe slots. So you don't need to buy an additional thing unless you are planning for a fourth graphics card. Okay. And of course, putting a graphics card on a riser will give it better cooling options, where you can attach more fan to it or place it externally, something like that. But it all takes so much of space, time and energy, guys. Why you want to waste those things? So next is your cooling solutions. It is also personal choice. For example, for this current setup which I have, I don't have any additional cooling support than the existing fans. And what I found out was that I had an extra fan in one of my rigs. I removed it and placed it on the top of the cabinet, which actually had enough space to place three fans. What I found out that there was 2 degree drop in temperature when I put that fan with a completely closed cabinet, with the tempered glass on. Usually my temperature was around 68-67 degrees Celsius on both cards, and after I put this extra fan on top of it, there has been significant reduction in the temperature. That is, 2 degree reduction is significant when you consider it in a long term. Okay. So that is it. Then this, guys, UPS, don't take any options. Just go for it. Buy a very good UPS, minimum 1 kV. I forgot to mention that you need a minimum 1 kV UPS. 650, you won't get enough backup. 1 kV UPS in a background mode will run around 15 to 30 minutes. If you can get your hands on a good inverter also, it's good. But I won't recommend you to connect a PC to an inverter setup, because even a slight switching delay will cause your PC to shut down completely or cause error, glitches and all those things. So better option is to go for 1 kV UPS, especially in India where you have intermittent power outages. 1 kV UPS is very good, and you can connect that to an inverter supply, which will get charged vice versa. But as per pure sine wave theory, if you connect an inverter to this UPS or UPS to inverter, the UPS battery will slowly get damaged because you have to have a discharge in between. Or you can do a manual discharging cycle every once in a week, which will improve your battery life also. So that's it, guys. So this entire setup, processor, RAM, motherboard, graphics card, power supply, storage, two types of storages, cabinet, and an accessory riser. I have not included cooling setup because I don't think it is essential. And IV guard UPS will cost you around roughly around 1,33,400 rupees in current Indian market. Okay, it can go up to 1,50,000 or it can come down as much as 1,25,000 depending upon where you buy it and how you buy it. So these are all on online prices. These are all not retail prices and it is not the MRP or SRP. These are all average prices. So that's it, guys. Then additionally, if you have a keyboard, mouse and headphone, use it, or else you can go for these options. These are all very good options. This is the Redragon. Redragon, unlike the earlier times, now the Redragon keyboards are much, much better. They have actually come in the top 10 list of many reviewers. So Redragon Kumara K552 is very good keyboard, which is a wired type of keyboard. If you want wireless, you can go for wireless. But wireless keyboards will have a latency issue while gaming competitively. And the Razer Death Adder Essential Mouse is irreplaceable, guys. You go for it, you buy it. It's a very good mouse for this price, $2,200. You can buy it eyes closed. It's a very good mouse. So headphone, I search for a lot of headphones, and personally I'm not a huge fan of headphones. But if you want surround headphones, something like that, you might have to shell up to 20-25 thousand, in that range. If you are that into gaming, streaming and all those stuff, you can go for that. But I will go for a cheaper version like this, which has a mic, which is flexible and has a good headphone. So this is Razer Kraken X, guys, $4,000. So this plus all these three, it will come around 1,42,300. So your total budget will be ranging like 50,000. So now I'll fetch in you some additional information. Since our Gigabyte 450 Aorus Pro Wi-Fi and our gold 650 VA gold rated PSU can support up to 3 or 4 of these cards, we can go to 3 cards. So if you want to add that also, okay, so right now the cost is somewhere 52 to 30, so you can add another 1,50,000 to this, so roughly it will be 3 lakhs. So this would be a very good mining setup for the money you spend, and you can also game on that. But I won't recommend you buying 3 GPUs. Okay, you can, instead of that, you can buy, maybe like me, you can buy a 1050 Ti, or even better, you can go for an AMD graphics card, which is way much cheaper with better performance in some mining coins, some coins which can be mined. But it all is unnecessary, guys. With the RTX 3060 LHR, you can get around 40-42 hash rates in Autolycos, which you can mine ergo, and you can keep it. Sometimes the price will go up in the near future, you can sell it. So that's it, guys. Next, stay tuned. I'll be putting up a mining isolated rig and an alternative Intel mining rig soon. Please post your comments in the below header. Thank you, guys. Stay tuned. Do press the like button, do press subscribe, and press the bell icon and select to all. Thank you, guys.